Good day, grade 11 students! Another day and another learning for all of you. Before we proceed to our lesson that we are going to discuss for today, let's have first a short recap from what we have learned last week. So here it is. Last week, we discussed the types of speech contexts such as intrapersonal communication and interpersonal communication. Under interpersonal communication, we have dyad communication, small group, public, and mass communication. We also tackled the different types of speech styles. We have intimate, casual, consultative, formal, and frozen. So, for today's discussion, we will be discussing speech acts. When we say speech acts, these are the actions done by saying them. It is also defined as the utterance that a speaker makes to achieve an intended effect. Learning about speech acts will enhance your knowledge of communication and help you become more capable of responding to what people say, as well as utter the correct sentences that you need to influence others. There are three types of speech context according to J.L. Austin, 1962, in every utterance given the right circumstances and context. We have locutionary act, elocutionary act, and perlocutionary act. When we say locutionary act, it is the speaking part of the speech context. This simply means that in this type of speech context, you are saying something with a certain meaning in a traditional sense. While in an elocutionary act, it is not just saying something itself, but the act of saying something with the intention of stating an opinion, confirming or denying something, making a prediction, a promise, a request, issuing an order or decision, and giving an advice or permission. And when we say perlocutionary act, it is the resulting act of what is said. It is the response to an elocutionary act. So it can be multiple acts because there are many ways of responding to an elocutionary act. Example.
Anong kailangan kong gawin?
So as you can see on the sample scenario, the utterance of the girl, mukhang masarap yan ah, produces a literal meaning which serves as our locutionary act. But her intention for saying that is for the boy to give her some, which serves as our elocutionary act, because the utterance has social function in mind. And the boy's response, "Sorry, naubos ko na eh," is our perlocutionary act because it shows the utterance that gives an effect to do something. So let's proceed now to Charles' classification of speech acts. The first one is what we call assertive. It is a type of elocutionary act in which a speaker expresses belief about the truth of a proposition. Some examples of assertives are suggesting, putting forward, swearing, boasting, and concluding. Example.
Hi, ang ganda ko talaga. Mas maganda ako sa'yo. Ako ang pinakamaganda sa balat ng lupa. Sinabi sa akin ng boyfriend ko, no? Siya lang nagsabi sa'yo. Ako nga pag sumali tayo ng beauty contest, ako, for sure, ako ang mananalo. Eh ikaw, kahit at ang Miss Congeniality, hindi mo makukuha eh. Aba, ang yabang nito. Alam mo, suggest ko sa'yo girl, huwag ka nang sumali. Kasi kahit sa panaginip, di ka mananalo. Mas maganda kasi ako sa'yo. Ako kaya? Hoy, tumahimik nga kayo. Pareho kayong pangit.
The second one is what we call directive. It is a type of elocutionary act in which the speaker tries to make the addressee to perform an action. Some examples of a directives are asking, ordering, requesting, inviting, advising, and begging. Example,
Hoy Petra! Magugas ka nga doon? Nay naman eh. Isa. Ito na po.
The third one is commissive. It is a type of elocutionary act which commits the speaker to do something in the future. Examples of a commissive are promising, planning, vowing, and betting. Example,
Nay. Oh, ano yun? Simula po ngayon, di na po ako magpapasaway. Susunod na po ako lagi sa mga utos niyo, Nay. Aba! Very good yan, anak. Proud ako sa'yo, anak. Nay, pwede pahingi ng 150 pan-load lang.
The fourth one is expressive. It is a type of elocutionary act in which a speaker expresses his or her feelings or emotional reactions. Some examples of expressing are thanking, apologizing, welcoming, and deploring. Example,
Nay, sorry po Nay, di na po mauulit, promise po Nay. Nako Petra, hindi mo na ako madadaan sa ganyan mo, ha? Patawarin mo na ako, Nay. Oo pong nagsisisi na ako. Alam ko po yung hirap ni Nay. Pasensya na po kung pasaway ako. Hindi po talaga mauulit, Nay. Promise po.
Sige, nak. Basta bawas-bawasan na ang pagpapasaway, ha?
Opo, Nay. Thank you po.
The fifth and the last one is what we call declaration. It is a type of elocutionary act which brings a change in the external situation. Some examples of declaration are blessing, firing, baptizing, passing a sentence, and excommunicating. Example,
Hey, bayan, late na naman ako. Lagot na naman ako kay boss na ito.
One eternity later.
Late ka na naman, Miss Maggie ba? Ma'am, kasi ganito po kasi yun, ma'am.
I don't need your explanation.
Paulit-ulit lang naman yung sinasabi mo.
Well, I have an idea, para hindi ka naman eh.
Ano po yun, ma'am?
You're fired.
Anong kailangan kong gawin upang malaman?
And that's all for our discussion for today. If you have questions and clarification about this lesson, you can send it to me through our group chat. Thank you for watching!